My
God. Can you believe this? April 7th. April 7th at about 8 in the morning, and it's snowing. That's where the satellite truck was. It's gone now. But that's not important. Look at this. I mean, there's snow everywhere. It's coming down. And it's April. It's just supposed to be spring. Maybe it does this every morning at this time. I'm never up at this time. For God's sake, look at that. It's going to be quite a job ahead of me just digging out of this place. Well, I've got to get to the radio station. Oh, but first, I guess I have to deal with the animal. Where is the damn thing anyway? Dog talk snow, you know. There he is. I suppose you want to run around and frolic a little bit, eh? Well, go ahead. Oh, come on, you've seen snow before. Go ahead, go get it. There you go. Do what you have to do. That's what he has to do. And he does it quite well, doesn't he? Okay, come on. Come on. You ever find a car in your driveway, you don't know whose it is? This is a complete, total alien car. No idea who this is. It's in the best parking space, too. Oh, well, what are you going to do? Well, several things come to mind, but let's get on with today's business. Today is April 7th, as I mentioned. It's hard to believe, but it is. The third day of the second WUSB Radiothon. We're currently begging for money. And the first day went kind of badly. The second day went much better. This is the third day, which I call the pivotal day. Where the hell is my car? There it is. Oh boy, now I gotta dig out some... Well, that's not too bad, I guess. As long as I brought my keys with me, which I believe I did. Let's see, which key could it be? Not that key. There it is. I see it. Look, if you can't get the key in the keyhole, you shouldn't be driving. There we go. Okay. Let's open it up. And there's my car. Yep, that's the way I like to remember my car. Mostly clean, but a little bit dirty. Anyway, let's get inside there. And, well, battery light just started flashing, so I'm going to stop recording and pick this up a little bit later on. Yeah. Even more unbelievable than the snow is the fact that it took me 10 minutes to find a parking space. It's 8 in the morning on a day when there's no school. Something's going on here. I don't know what. But I don't like it. It's an imposing structure, isn't it? And that's what we're trying to move. Bad, stupid thing. It's causing all this trouble. Oh well. Let's get on with it. There'd be a swim meet or something going on in there. Rather picturesque, I guess. Of course, that effect. Up this thing is always fun, but when it's snowy outside, you'd be assured of getting completely soaked. give you an idea of how wet this is. Several feet have sunk. Ooh. I'm sorry that I couldn't record walking up the steps, but I had to concentrate on walking, and it was a bit more important. There's the 45-degree handicap wrap. Don't ever try going up that thing, bicycle or anything like that. 90-degree blind turn. Stony Brook specialty. Alright. In a moment, we'll look out over the bridge to what used to be nowhere. And sort of walking in puddles. It's now pretty much the same thing. There it is. And that's the library. Incredible. Now we're going to walk into the radio station. In a completely unrehearsed scene here. In fact, nobody knows that I'm coming with this thing. For God's sake. Doors locked. I can't believe this for the hassle. Not the kind of thing I want to be doing on a Saturday morning when it's snowing outside. Let's see. Can you focus on those? I can't see which key is which. Oh, I'll take it out of camera. My eyes can see better than this thing can. Alright, no, it's not that set. It's this set here. It's the middle key. Alright, we're going to do this, folks. We're going to do this as I've done hundreds of times before. Get it first the wrong way and then turn it the right way. The door is now open. Now we can step inside the Union Building. Oh, this is nice. Because they have heat. Oh, let's take a look at what's going on here. We have a Radiothon. I wonder what that's all about. Fascinating. Fascinating. And then something else as well. A concert. Oh, this certainly is something. There's quite a bit going on here. Quite a bit indeed. Alright. Well, there it is outside again, but we don't need to see that anymore. Let's walk inside. Hopefully not walk into anything. Official hallway. There's a studio in there. We'll look at that later.
I'm hard at work for the radio time.
Well, that's a fine way to say hello. I'm just going to say hi, Eric. Can I be you
doing
this?
I'm sorry.
I mean, the fact that I'm holding a camera shouldn't influence you at all.
It didn't. I just made a comment.
Well, it sounded like you were talking to an audience.
Really?
Yeah, it did sound that way.
Did it?
Saying you were hard at work.
You're an audience of sorts.
Well, yeah, I am. I'm also a person. So, this is the place, eh?
Mm-hmm. Is this the microphone over there?
Yep, that thing is the microphone.
Mm.
And that's the lens. And your face filling up the lens.
Mm.
What do we have in here? We have a bunch of happy people or a bunch of miserable, sad, upset people?
Mm. Miserable what, Tom?
Well, how are we doing?
Not too good.
I see. Really?
Mm-hmm.
How not too good?
We got one call from Jay Gaspin making a pledge.
so far.
One call. Mm-hmm. He's already pledged $200.
Pardon?
He's already pledged $200.
Mm-hmm. I think he pledged again.
Oh, boy. Any other calls?
Not that I know of. Well, I guess two. We've had two.
Boy, well, sounds like you guys need my help, so I'm going to put this thing down.
Take our pictures, that'll help.
Yeah, well. This is the official. Hi there. Good. What's up? Let's take a look at the official tally screen there. I don't know if we can focus on that. But those numbers sure do look miserable. And there's a miserable DJ in there who's trying to raise funds. I think Norm is... There's Norm.
Why don't you give this as a premium?
No, I don't think I'll do that.
Okay.
Norm is walking out. He's walking out. That means soon he'll be walking in.
Yep.
And I've got to better turn this thing off for my own good.
This one, and I initially putted up this one,
oh.
So then I switched over to that one.
Oh, well. But they both, one of them wasn't running these, who wasn't working a couple days ago. So.
Okay, I think this guy has an occasional intermittency problem.
Oh, I see.
Tapped.
I see.
Right.
Well, don't tap the microphones. What do you want to do a thing like that for?
Levels
up to
NW's frequency.
So it is.
All right, let's zing him.
So we're going to ask for money?
Well, it's an idea.
All right.
Is that
capturing this moment?
Pardon?
Is that capturing this moment?
Oh, you want me to capture it? I don't know about that. I might get away if I try to capture it.
I got to talk on the radio here.
Oh, okay. So,
what are you doing? Have you one of these machines before?
Actually, no, I haven't.
Okay, well, you put your hand through there, and you see this little thing there? You go that way, and you zoom, and it's like a knob. You can zoom in and out.
This
yeah.
Over here?
Yeah, that's autofocus right there. It'll focus for you. You just stare through
great.
That thing.
Great.
And if you need to stop it for any reason, you press the red button. Near where your thumb is.
Near where my thumb is. That's good. Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you. It's amazing. I'm looking through it, and I see Gordon. I take it away, and I still see Gordon.
That's because he's still there.
So it's almost as if there's, and the same thing for Jerry and for you and yeah, it's autofocus, all right.
Amazing. I get to tangle these things up.
Of course, if I sweep very quickly across the room, I defeat the autofocus. Sweep very quickly the other way.
Yes. Can't keep up with
it. No. How whimsical of me.
Short end of the line there.
Yeah.
That's what you get.
Okay, I'll help a little
bit. Look at all the stoop. Stoop.
How's the mic pick up on this?
Premiums are in focus on?
I don't know, you told me too. An autograph can't keep
it. Yeah, it's focused on that.
Fantastic.
Black
and blue.
I'd like to hear
that.
No, that was black and blue.
What happens if I drop this?
Where's
break?
No hardship.
Figure it's Saturday morning. The microphone's on? Up?
Yeah, that's
fine. Oh, okay. Well, we had it on for a good hour yesterday.
Yes. I know.
Oh,
I kept trying to call.
Yeah, live and everything. I don't know what
was wonderful.
Mostly letters of
it's a snowy morning. It's early Saturday. People are still sleeping. They're waking up to us now. Let's tell them that it's not a day for driving. Like cold day outside.
Do we have a weather forecast?
Sure do. Okay, let's read the weather and tell them that.
Okay.
We know what's going on, and they don't. They need us. If they want to tell them the right information, they better give us some money.
Uh-oh. Mean streets.
It's caused a lot of trouble by spreading false information.
That's right.
Temperatures in the 70s today. That's right. It's a good beach day, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. Although Chris Crowley did that, sort of, you know, he predicted that a Thursday in the middle of the winter was going to be warm enough to go to the beach because it was his day off.
It was.
Yeah, it was.
Got the most screwed up weather.
Yeah.
Oh, we can talk about this a bit. A weather wrap.
Wrap up that weather.
Let's try to get 80 by 9 o'clock. Talk about what USB means and what it would be like to listen to it.
Boggles the mind.
Feel free to get impassioned. Just bang on the table. Where is Great River anyway?
It's, oh good.
No, did you know?
Yes, it's on the south shore, you know where Islip is?
Yeah.
You know where Oakdale is?
Yeah.
Great River is just east of Oakdale.
I mean, it's just west of Oakdale.
Between Islip
is
and
really
Oakdale.
Is it really small or something? Because I've never
heard of it. It's pretty small, yeah. Matter of fact, the Long Island Railroad doesn't always even stop there.
Like
on
Islandia, I've never heard of that either.
Yeah, that's a new hamlet.
That town,
yeah.
Right in town. What was it before?
Right.
Nothing.
It was a certain area.
An industrial.
Maybe around Bohemia, was it? Is that?
Well, it's north of Bohemia, south of Wisconsin.
Mm.
Basically nowhere land.
Mm.
Yeah. And they decided to incorporate it as the town of Islandia in 1985.
Right.
So it's really quite recent.
Wow.
Yep. And now there's the Islandia Hilton, and there's the...
Is there its own zip code?
I think so. I think it does.
Well,
maybe. Yeah.
Certainly when Computer Associates finishes its new site there, it will have to have its own post office.
I guess so. Sobering words there.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Washington, stand by for a message. Oh, no, an update. Did we get something?
Yes.
What did we get?
$50.
$50, yeah.
Yay, all right.
Who is that person?
Lundy.
Lundy? Let's make sure we thank that person.
Okay,
yeah. Yeah, how do we thank the person? I guess the person is the person.
Franklin's Tower, The Grateful Dead, from the Cambodian Refugees Concert at Oakland Coliseum, in 1980.
What a nice clean recording that was.
Indeed, that's what I like to present.
That's very nice music to wake up to, and yes folks, it's snowing outside.
It's snowing outside. It's April 7th. I woke up this morning and I looked out the window and I said, whoa, what's going on here? This is,
You're not the only one.
This is not right. We read the forecast last night here. And we got into a bit of a debate. Okay, it was a bit of a fist fight, but nothing serious, nothing serious, and we'll pay for the damages. But the thing is, snow in April just isn't supposed to happen. Now, we've had some pretty messed up weather over the last couple of months. We've had some 70-degree days in the middle of January. Yeah, now we got snow in April. What's going on?
You know what reminds me of? I'm from New England, and it reminds me of New England weather. And people always say in New England, if you don't like the weather, wait a minute. And I think that reminds me of WUSB. Because if you don't like what you're hearing at that particular moment, you can hang around, and there's going to be an extraordinary range of music and talk and information coming along.
Well, today alone, we've got the Grateful Dead concert coming up at 10 o'clock.
Right.
It's even in Newsday.
Wow.
Newsday saw fit to cover this one. Around April 5th, 1971, the Howard Stein dance benefit or whatever.
First annual Grateful Dead dance marathon.
And it is a marathon to go with our marathon. That concert lasts about 3 hours and 30 minutes, I think. And it's in good condition. We got that straight off a digital transfer from the master tape. It's going to sound pretty good, folks. And we'll give you every opportunity to get your cassettes ready, and we won't talk over the songs or anything nasty like that. But we do need your help, and we're going to get into that in just a moment. But first, more importantly, we want to tell you what the weather forecast is, and we also want to advise you to be careful out there, because I just drove over here, and it's pretty slippery, because folks don't expect the roads to be slippery in April, certainly.
That's right.
There's some ice forming. You got to watch it. So drive slowly, if you have to drive at all. Otherwise, why not just sit back, relax, listen to the radio, because we're here to keep you folks happy.
Particularly WUSB. Radio-wise. Eric's right. Driving I live about a mile and a half from here, and it was an adventure. The plows are not out. I don't think they will be. They've probably been put away for the summer. And definitely sit back and look forward to the snow ending by late afternoon.
Late afternoon.
That's right.
But if, wait a minute. Whoa! If it keeps snowing from now until late afternoon, there must be some kind of accumulation expected, eh?
Well, according to the official printout, it says little or no accumulation. I disbelieve that.
Well, there's accumulation right now.
Precisely. At least an inch and a half.
Can't believe
inches.
That thing. I look out the window. Trust your eyes, folks. It's sticking to the ground there. So be careful.
Yeah.
It's what, 1 degree Celsius now, 34 Fahrenheit.
That's correct.
Maybe it's not going to freeze all that much. It's going to get pretty gosh darn close.
Temperature hasn't changed since I came in here at about 6:30 this morning.
Hasn't changed.
It has not changed.
Oh, it's still coming down.
Uh-huh. Yes, a peek out the WUSB weather window has confirmed that for myself as well. However, tomorrow is supposed to be considerably better, mostly sunny, with highs in the low 50s, which... Well, if we can believe them, that should take care of any accumulations that have occurred today.
Make some nice mud puddles.
Right.
It's really beautiful out, though. I mean, it's clinging to the branches, so if you just want to sit in the living room and open the curtains and listen to the radio, you get something really pretty to look at, too.
Yeah, it's kind of a surprise, and Long Island is known for its surprises.
Indeed.
And one surprise is WUSB, the fact that we're even here. Is a surprise to many of us because the odds of this station actually making it onto the air were kind of dim at some points in the 70s.
That's right.
There was a tremendous race for frequencies, and we just happened to be on top of things back then. And we should thank those people that that worked almost 24 hours a day to get this radio station on the air back in 1977. Actually, they started well before then to make this radio station FM, and it was only in 1977 that their efforts culminated in success, and that success has lasted to this day. But we want to take it one step further. We're taking that second step. We want to be able to move our transmitter to a higher location so that all of you, and I don't think anybody won't be affected by this, so that all of you will be able to get a better signal and a more consistent signal, a signal that will last for longer distances. For instance, if you're driving out east or driving to the south of Long Island or wandering around somewhere in Connecticut, we want that signal to be able to come in strong, and the only way we can get to that point is to be able to move our transmitter. We have a site in mind. We have specific particulars. We're looking at the engineering surveys, and it's a very exciting time for us because
something that we've been talking about, theorizing about, actually looks like it's going to happen. But there's one key ingredient, and that key ingredient is you. Excuse me. I'm choked up here, but that key ingredient is you, our listener. Our listeners, hopefully. Every dollar that we get this morning is going to go towards that move, towards that transmitter move, and that transmitter move is going to benefit each and every one of our listeners. So that's why it's so important for you to pick up the phone now and give us a call and show your support, because every little bit is going to add up. And just like every person here at the radio station makes it what it is, every one of our listeners can make this station into something even bigger and better.
Indeed. And the calls are starting to come in. A little while ago, we heard from Lundy of Stony Brook, who picked up one pair of the Arlo Guthrie Pete Seeger ticket. And very recently, we heard from Fred of Stony Brook. And we'd like to thank both of those. And we also, I see, have a caller from Patchogue most recently.
And Patchogue is one of those places that will most definitely be affected, because when I go to Patchogue, when I drive around there, the station kind of drifts in and out. In fact, there's some stations, I won't mention them by name, but there are some stations from Connecticut that come in even better than WUSB. Why is that? Are they more powerful? In some cases they are, but more importantly, they're higher up. I believe many stations broadcast from a place known as Booth Hill in Trumbull. Mm-hmm. And that's a high location. And when you get high up on the FM side of things, you reach for longer periods of space. FM is line of sight, so the higher up you get, the longer distances you'll be able to cover. We want to be able to be in that league. We want to be able to extend our signal outwards. And there is a certain sense of urgency here, too, because if we're not successful in this, there are other stations. There are two applications for the frequency of 89.9 out east. And if those applications go through before our application to expand our 90.1 frequency goes through, we won't be able to do it, because there'll be a station out on eastern Long Island that we won't be able to reach out to eastern Long Island, because we'll have to protect that station. And I might add, both of those applications will be little more than simulcasting operations for existing radio stations. They won't be for a station like WUSB, they'll be for stations that broadcast national programs. And I'm not putting the national programs down, but I'm saying this is a community radio station. Everybody you hear on this radio station is from around here. They come in, they do live programs. We've gotten up at very early hours in the morning to come down here and talk to you. And we're here every day doing this. There aren't very many stations like WUSB, and we want WUSB to be preserved. And we want to be able to reach more Long Islanders, more people in Connecticut. And we know that you want that too. We received something close to 2,000 responses when we first made it known that our frequency was in danger out in the eastern part of Long Island and I guess part of Connecticut as well. Yes?
Hello?
It's true.
It is.
Mike Uhas is back.
I'm here.
Just when you thought it was safe to listen to the radio again.
Sure. Jim, how you doing?
Right, how are you? Good to see you.
Good to see you too. What's new with you? Remember, we're on videotape.
So these are the original introductions. We're not restaging them for the audience at home. This is actually live as it happens, unaffected by... Just pretend I'm not here. Unaffected by any outside influence at all.
Yeah, yes, you're seeing it.
And that's Mike Uhas' face, and that's my camera lens.
Ah!
Well, it's not supposed to be like that. There's a gym. There's Gordon going through some exciting teletype copy there.
Excuse me?
Yeah, you're excused.
Oh, my God.
Who knows what kind of news he's reading about? Exciting weather forecasts. Oh, the phone is ringing. Get inside of that phone ringing. There we go. That is the pledge line there. That is the pledge line.
Excellent.
All right, let's close right in on that scary pledge line. There we go. Oh, scary, boys and girls. Ah, yes. They're kind of blurry, too, but that's just the way it goes. Oh, Jimmy McDexter. Hey.
That's me, lad.
Hey, it's you came all the way over here from where?
I came a great huge stretch of vast and wide, all the way from over near Cedar Street in Sunnybrook.
Well, what do you think of this weather here, huh?
I'm not too happy about it, quite frankly.
No.
Not at all.
But there's not really much you can
do
about it.
This is April, and April, well, yeah, as I mentioned to Jim Calder earlier, we're living in the middle of a Prince song. Sometimes it snows in April. That's what's happening.
Is that a Prince song?
It is a Prince song. It should be played at some point today, I think. Apropos in the extreme.
Well, maybe we can find that in our vast record library.
Apropos song du jour here at WUSB.
All right. That's not a legal ID, but it's close enough. So, how do you compare this to last year at this point?
Well, it kind of feels like we never left last year. It's like a continuation of this incredible party train thing that's happening. Mm.
Life can be like that.
Life is like that.
Mm-hmm. So I hear.
It's been a remarkable week for just about everybody I know, and here we are having fun at Radiothon 90, and I don't know. I'm kind of warming into it now. I'm feeling kind of stupid a lot of the time, especially...
Stupid!
I'm greatly unbrilled.
One thing we do have is all these nice awards and plaques and things that are up on the wall here. They fall down occasionally because they're put up with tape. But that's okay. We don't care about that. Here's our 90.1 club from last year. And look at all those nice people. Yeah, well, let's not look too long. We also have all kinds of posters from the past. And the first aid kit, of course, the official first aid kit.
And don't forget, up here, if you pledge to us, and then you never send us the little check and stuff, what happens? There are penalties.
Whoa.
Penalties. We know where you live. Penalties.
All right.
Or at least we know the address that you gave.
Right.
It's probably your house.
So whoever lives there, penalties. Severe penalties.
All right.
But then when they do pay eventually and take you out of jail, there's no more bailout.
All right. Well, I'm gonna do what's known as a documentary cut now. Now, everybody, hold on to their seats, and we're gonna
strap in.
Good Lord, where are we? I seem to be up high. Why am I up high?
You're up high because that's symbolism. We want to make the transmitter up high.
At least.
Oh, that's what it is. Symbolism. Symbol. Of course. How could I be so stupid?
Don't let him answer that one. Yeah.
Well, Jim, do that again with your head.
That?
You have these big glowing objects, and it's like you have eyes in the back of your head. Oh, you do have eyes in the back of your head. That's the most incredible.
That is due to the incredible length of my hair.
It is pretty long, isn't it?
You don't believe in personal grooming, do you?
Well, it's not so much that I don't believe in personal grooming as it is that I haven't got any damn money.
Ah, I know that quite well.
Yes. Absolutely. Look.
That sounds like money to me, huh? Look at that, though. That is something else.
That is bad.
So I suppose we won't be seeing pledges from you people, will we?
Well, absolutely, you will be seeing pledges from us people.
Because...
You mean you'll be stealing the money, eh?
No, clearly, this radio station means a lot more to him...
Than life itself.
...than his personal appearance.
Well, that seems quite obvious. Well, I'll leave that as the final word. Sorry.
We're on camera now.
Now, what's the question?
Do you know anything about a matching fund?
A matching fund? Did we, is there a matching fund?
No.
Did someone mention a matching fund?
Okay, well,
would they like to make a matching fund?
You said that you'd like to pledge
$50. What is
a
matching fund?
Your boss would, and he was interested in finding out about a matching fund. Okay, we don't do matching funds.
Oh, yeah, we do, sure. Do they want to make a matching fund?
We do matching funds. Yeah. Oh, yeah, sure. let me get down your information.
This is what we like to see. We like to see busy volunteers. As you can see, three people, count them, three people on the phone. At any second, this phone could ring. And this person is not on the phone. Could be on the phone
soon. We want the phone to ring.
Right. And if only two more phones ring, two more, then nobody else will be able to call in, which is bad, I guess. But it's good in a way, too, because that means five people are calling at once. Yes.
These are the most pledges I've seen being taken at one time.
Well, actually, last night was pretty busy, too.
Yeah, I figured the reggae guys would make some money.
Yes.
Great. Watching Town 13.
And,
thank you.
You're moving.
Okay, so I guess your last name is Dexter.
And as you can see, we're doing some talking on the air right now. Let's let's join them in progress and move to master control.
We just about have a bingo.
That's right. Can we have a bingo from Mike?
WUS bingo.
WUS bingo. Oh, no. That's like a WUS Beatle music lovers who are going to get their just desserts tonight.
A contribution of $35 makes you a contributing supporter.
I hear the phone.
It gives you a program guide subscription for a year, a bumper sticker that you can place on your bumper, or, as I always say, on your car's bumper, and a USB t-shirt, a wonderful USB t-shirt, which, what does it say this year?
I don't know. They're waving at me from the other room.
Maybe they want you to pick up the phone or something?
Yeah, it's hard to do with headphones on.
Well, that's good. I guess I'm just going to have to battle on here by myself.
I'll be leaving.
Placing us all here in charge, huh? Eric, why don't you sit down in that chair?
How can I sit down when I'm filming?
Oh, Eric's making a docudrama here with his wonderful brand-new camcorder. Please do give us a call at 516-632-6901. We do need to hear from you.
One more call would make a bingo. Oh, please do the one.
Yes, please do. We need to hear from you. This radio station, we need to hear from
now,
you.
Now, think about it, folks. Think about this. If we get a bingo, this will be, I think, our first bingo, and it will be on film. We're filming the phone right now. So if you call in, it'll be captured for all time, both on the radio and on the phone.
The phone number is 516-632-6901. We're here for your entertainment.
I've got one of these newfangled machines right now that...
we need to hear from you this morning at 516-632-6901. The reason why we're doing this is so we can improve our signal to you. Please do give us a call now at 516-632-6901. A $50 pledge makes you a sustaining supporter, gets you the program guide for a year, a bumper sticker, a USB t-shirt, and... a USB coffee mug. Lovely limited edition coffee mug that you'll be proud to drink coffee from, or any other beverage. Or if you don't drink beverages, perhaps you could pot a plant in it. That's what I did with
mine. Wow, that would be great, because it's blue, you know, blue and green.
Oh,
just
lovely.
Just in time for Earth Day.
Just lovely, lovely colors. Please give us a call at 516, oh, you know the number.
That's right.
No, you don't.
632-6901. All my listeners have it written on the wall right over the kitchen phone, right?
And by this point, most of you have it embedded in your brains.
That's right.
Because you call it from time to time. You request music. You call it for ticket giveaways that we do from time to time. We're now asking you for something back. It's your show of support to this radio station that's part of your lives. Please give us a call now. Do we have any premiums that we're offering
now? Yes, we do have some premiums. We have a one-year subscription to Irish America magazine, and if you read the Irish Voice, it's the same fine people who publish both, and up to the minute information and some great articles and beautiful color photography all about life here in America for the Irish. So
and how much would we need?
$35
for
a mere $35.
What's the name of this publication?
Irish America.
You probably can't even find that on the newsstands too easily.
No, you can't. You really have to be a subscriber.
So please give us a call.
That.
Those folks have donated a subscription for your pleasure, for your enjoyment, to make this radio station successful. We need to hear from you now at 516-632-6901.
That's right. And if you already subscribe to Irish America and you're saying, gee, I'd like to contribute my $35, what am I going to get? You could either get a free WUSB t-shirt, or you could get a pair of tickets to any show at 33 in Port Jasper. They're showing their support to us by giving us these tickets.
Give us a call now. The phone lines, we have a couple of them are open. And did we get a couple more callers that time?
Yeah, we didn't get the bingo. Somebody finished their call before the end. So we would really, really love to have these people busy. Oh, come on. Ed Davis is in there now. The guy never does anything. Give him a call. Make him work. If you've been listening for the last 2 days, you know.
I hope he's not
that
listening.
That was a sardonic comment. Ed's been here He's one of the champions of the station. He'll tell you about WUSB and what it means to him anytime, night or day, and give you the best of what's going on here.
One of the most important things to Jerry Reamer here, your unfailing host, your tireless host for Plan on Ale and other music programs here on 90.1, is that she needs to play music. That is her life's mission. And we can't do that until we hear a couple of more calls. Please give us a call now at 516-632-6901.
That's right, Nick. And thank you. Which is at home.
Barry's water, yes. This is what it's like sitting in the master control chair. Oh, you lose balance. Turn the volume up. And Mike will be starting up the middle cart here as soon as this record is over.
It'll be real soon.
If I get too close to that needle,
You're going to turn down the record, right?
No, I'm going to keep the record going throughout, Mike. Of course I'm going to turn down the record.
Well, I mean, you're closer to it than me.
I'm going to turn down... Don't panic, there's no need to panic. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
All right. I just hope the cart is ready and screwed up. Well, this is exciting, isn't it? This is what radio is all about. Pressing buttons and making sounds.
Oh, look at this.
Look at this. Look at what?
Poised
and ready to go.
Kind of like
that, eh?
Like that.
Go.
Hot stuff.
Hello, and thanks for joining us. We're visiting today with Larry the List Man.
That's right.
Somebody
I keep
be
lists
ready to talk
of everything.
You'll be ready to talk.
Well, I've got a list here of all 47
that on
adverbs that were spoken
are
in Gone with the Wind, including the most famous
what?
One, frankly.
I want
well, that's real impressive.
I thought so.
And I understand you brought your newest list with you.
Yes, this one's a biggie. I've gone ahead and comprised a full listing of all the different styles of music that you can't hear on the radio. There's bluegrass, salsa, ska, hip-hop, big band, hardcore, Indian, Irish, Chinese,
Larry.
Acid house, blues, reggae, soca, industrial, African, Haitian, Persian, polka.
Will you shut up for a second, Larry? There is a radio station where you can hear all of that, plus a whole lot more.
It's
WUSB in
Sweden.
You Sweden.
Know where to cut it off,
Long
right?
Island's largest non-commercial radio station. Well, you can hear almost any kind of music, as well as alternative news and public affairs. In fact, they're having an on-air fundraiser from April 5th through the 14th, so they can move the transmitter and reach even more people with alternative.
I guess this means all of my hard work has been a complete waste of time.
Well, before you get all depressed over your miserable failure, perhaps you could devise a new list. Could you come up with a list of reasons why people should support a station like WUSB?
Hey, what do I look like?
No, Larry, you don't, but that's what you would need in order to compile a list of all the things that go on WUSB, Stony Brook. Right, Mike?
That's absolutely true. That last break, we got a couple of calls. We need to hear from more folks this morning at 516-632-6901. We've been telling you about the various pledge levels. Did we mention the 90.1 club lately?
Not lately. Why don't you tell them about it?
Well, in addition to the program guide, the bumper sticker, which you can place on your bumper or your car's bumper, and the USB t-shirt, and the USB mug that you can place coffee in or plants, you also get a special certificate of recognition that says that you are appreciated. We know you're appreciated anyway, but this just makes it official. And plus, your name gets on a plaque that gets erected here at the radio station complex. That's for a pledge of $90.10, $90.1. To sort of commemorate 90.1 FM, the most dangerous station in the nation, I think we used to be known as.
I think we still are. And, you know, if you like round numbers, really round numbers, and you want to make that $100, we'll still put you on a 90.1 plaque. You know, we're not fussy like that. Right, Mike?
That's true.
We're very
but then again,
here.
You know, we'll take anything. We really need to hear from you this morning. Face it, Jerry, $90.1 is not within the means of a lot of folks. If you can donate $10 to this radio station, or $20, we would be happy to take that. You know, those kind of small donations mean even more to us, because it shows that you're really making a sacrifice to this radio station. Maybe going out without food for a couple of days, or maybe going without clothing, or something like that. Yes,
not in the snowy April, Mike, please. Please let's not do that to them. No, but, you know, we know that whatever you give involves some sacrifice on your part, that there's lots of other places your money could go, but we know how important WUSB is in your lives. We hear from you when we give away tickets, when we have questions, when we're just wondering if we're all alone up here, the phone will ring and someone will say, you know, great job, Mike, this is the most beautiful music I've ever heard, Jerry, whatever. And we know you're out there, and right now we need to know you're out there. So if you could give us a call at 516-632-6901.
Jim Dexter's mom called a little bit ago.
Yeah, she did. She brought up on my computer screen that, but Mrs. Mac Dexter showed her support of the station, and thank you. She told me she always has to like split her heart between the Celtic show and Jimmy's show. So. Thanks, Mom. And thanks to Mac down in Bohemia. And for his support, and we'd really like, well, we're one toward a bingo right now.
And not only that, we're also getting some support from local businesses in the community. USB would like to thank Waldbaum's of Stony Brook and Entenmann's Bakery for their kind support, providing refreshments to some of our listener volunteers. And you know,
cameraman is now Jim.
Jerry, that a lot of our listeners actually became radio persons. They came. Jay Gassman is one who comes to mind. Last year, he started out as a listener volunteer, answering your phone calls when we did this first ever Radiothon a year ago. And now he's on the air with us here on USBFM, and he's a darn good programmer too.
Yes,
we know
is.
There's more like you out there. Please do give us a call at 516-632. So what's the rest of the number? 516-632-6901. Right, that's it.
Right. That's the one. They've all got it firmly in mind now. That's true. I think when our listeners come up here and get to talk to other listeners, they realize they're not alone in how important radio is to them. I mean, sometimes people don't... Radio isn't important to a lot of people. They get prepackaged stuff on TV, and that's kind of okay for them. Radio takes a little more, I think. Calls on a little more in the listener, because go right ahead. Oh no! Remember when Eric got choked up before? He just kind of floated up ceilingward, and I know where he is. I'm not that naive in the world. He is not. Oh no! Wow, it's sort of mystical. Yeah. Well, I was telling Eric, 632-6901. We know where he is. Oh, what are you doing?
Now, you must know some noises then. Let's hear some of your repertoire, if possible.
Shows you the economy that we use around here. We did a Radiothon last year. We got a whole bunch of money in for this new transmitter. There was a little bit of money left over, and it enabled us to get a foot and a half cord for this set of headphones. If there's any money left over this year. Thank you for making a liar out of me. I'm just going to get out of here. Probably I'll go back to...
I don't know. Oh. Oh.
We are in master control.
Actually, we're not going to answer the phone. The folks, the listener volunteers that we have in the other room, they're going to answer your phone call. They're people just like you, people that listen to this radio station. It's part of their life. It's part of your life, too. We know that because you're listening at this very moment. Why else would you be listening to a bunch of people begging for money?
I'm not begging.
Okay, I am.
I never beg.
I am asking you to go to your phone, pick up the phone, dial the phone number 516-632-6901.
No.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you, Mr. Telephone Max.
That's right. We don't want you to damage yourself while making that all-important phone call.
That is the number. Please give us a call at the number that we just said. Make our day complete here at WUSB Stony Brook.
And speaking of our day, it's 11:01, and you tuned to Long Island's first station of the 90s, if you haven't figured that out yet. And where every week I try to bring you into the Celtic family, and Mary from Bayport just won one of those subscriptions to Irish America, and congratulations, Mary, and Gormahavet, which, if you haven't figured out yet, means thank you. And why don't we take a visit to the Celtic Hotel? Come on, guys. Thank you. Here comes the battlefield band, slowly but surely. Come on. That's good. Hey. 632-6901. There's no one in Ralph in the band.
Oh, well.
Why don't you figure out what it is that...
Okay. Eric is now the cameraman.
Give me that damn thing.
Yeah, it's about time.
It's a wonderful LP.
Wait, it's a whole lot of nonsense here. And still the snow persists. Well, not really, but certainly interesting for an April morning here. Well, we're here in the USB record library, the vast library. Like 40,000 records are in here. Wow. Let's wander through these. Ooh, fast style. It's a problem with carrying a camera. You don't see what's underneath you. Wow, look at that. They have records of every kind here. In fact, we had to break down a wall to store more records. This used to be part of the conference room. Now, Mike has just taken a USB button, and we've given him the challenge of getting you buttoned it. Every single one of those USB buttons has some kind of design defect on them.
He just played the score from Fanny.
He sat down and played the piano.
Jim, is there anything you need me here to do with the premiums?
Wait, can you come in again with that, Mike? With more emphasis on, is there anything I can do?
Is there anything I can do?
That's it.
I'm just one person.
Cut. Jim, speak into the microphone.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I want to be able to hear what you're saying.
I'm sorry. Well, the thing is, though, what I'm doing, you see, demands my attention over in this direction. So if I were to do this, it would be a very contrived, meaningless exercise.
Okay, now if you can put that kind of emphasis into the lines you're supposed to say, I think everything will be fine.
Oh, the lines you're supposed to say?
Yeah.
Oh, is this a take?
Yeah, this was a take, and film is expensive.
Okay, I'm sorry.
All right. Quiet on the set.
Just give me the ghost.
That was the ghost. Go ahead.
Action.
Continue.
Okay. Rodolfo, how dare you?
It's a rap. Whatever you call the damn thing, that's what it is.
Thank you.
Thank you.
We certainly have a whole handful of things. We do. We do.
You're going to try to put on a button. See how long this takes. None of the buttons work.
It's
very hard to do it on your own.
This is the test.
We have probably 500 test buttons.
And I pass.
Well, oh wow, people are getting pretty good at this.
You consider the test seat.
It
took me half an hour to get one on the other day.
Oh, you want to change the show after this?
Yeah.
No button with this? This is a cross button.
Earrings. We're giving away earrings.
Look. We are.
I'll check it to see.
Yeah, I think we need some new premiums.
What's up?
The responsibilities of the station manager involve talking to...
Yes, I know that, but I just want to know if you wanted at this point...
...can drive you crazy.
You know, we do this show by show, and I don't know if this show necessarily is the time you're going to use it.
As long as we're on the phone for six hours.
Then tomorrow, if you could call again during Charlie's time, that would be helpful. No, just call. We'll be all here, but, you know, we're doing things literally 10 minutes at a time, so that's the way you need to do it.
He wants to hang up the phone in the next 10 seconds.
It's going. So if you could... It's wild. So call then, and then we'll take care of it.
4, 3,
okay, thanks a lot.
2,
bye-bye.
1. Got him down to a second here.
Down to a dial tone.
Yeah. Rodolfo, what are you grinning about here?
Oh, nothing at all.
Uh-huh.
I always look this way.
You got something that you want to share with the rest of us?
No, I'm
What's
just,
so funny? Let's
just
talking
in the ambience. Uh-huh. Volunteer radio.
Perhaps it will break.
Don't you have perhaps responsibilities elsewhere
perhaps
in the station?
Break.
Yes,
will
I do.
Break.
I have to go for attending? Some money in the... I have to check to make sure the funds are coming in.
Yes.
Batteries die. Later.
We're all in good luck. All right, so Jim, you got to give me that press release as soon as possible.
I know.
If we're hurting with publicity on this.
News release.
Hurting bad.
If I zoomed in on the VUs.
Do we have premiums picked up? Oh, these are Lister's premiums?
You have to zoom in on the computer screen, too, at the 5,000 mark. Or over the 5,000 mark.
Yeah, you know, I noticed that it doesn't really focus well on the numbers. It focuses on the screen, but then not on the numbers.
Well, yeah. Because the numbers are behind the screen, right?
Yeah, I guess so. Oh, that's the date. I was wondering what date it was. April 7th, right, of course. If only I knew what time it was. Thank you. Oops. This thing was not set for daylight savings time.
I answered the call and all I wanted to do
it's actually an hour later than this.
It's Wisconsin time.
It's Wisconsin time, right, of course.
Oh, all right. Then.
All right. Here we have a helpful room filled with volunteers. And computer operators.
Oh, my
pleasure. And there's DJ in there.
You can answer it. You know how to do this?
No, nobody's giving me any training.
Oh, it's real simple. Get yourself.
Okay. He's getting calls to come in right now.
Just
even as
do
we speak.
What it says.
Yeah, just
except remember where it says for official use only.
Don't write it.
Oh, the printout's printing the value of the premium to the right.
How do I get that damn time off?
I know.
Yeah,
one of
my big ambitions
is that
someday I
want to
write
one of these boxes. Coming through here. I just hope I don't run into anything.
Let's do the
horror film effect as we run through the hallways. The control rooms must be in here. Ooh, it's only my head.
Oh my God.
No problem.
Rick and pile up here to get to the second part of the Radiothon and WUSB. Is Jim around? How did you make out this morning, Jersey? How did you make out?
We had some great listeners, and I know you're going to have some this afternoon.
Did it reach the 500 mark?
5,000.
5,000 miles?
Yeah, we're over.
Oh, really?
Yay.
Hey, congratulations.
Yeah. Well, I told them we had to have 5,000 before Lister got in here.
That's cool.
So we did it.
Let's get those phones lit up. Last year we had a thing where we tried to light up line number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. One time we had a little $5 bet behind the scenes to get things off the ground. So we haven't gotten any phone calls here. This thing doesn't look like a Christmas tree. It's like an empty cherry bowl to me. 516-632-690.1 FM.
You know what I think, Lister?
Yeah.
I think the folks want to hear music. Once you start playing some music, we're going to get some calls. What do you think?
I was playing some music before, but I didn't get any calls. That's the only reason why I stopped, because, it's supposed to be like a real radio sound. Come on. 516-632-690.1 FM.
All right, you heard the man. 632-6901. Let's play some music, and let's hear some calls from you guys.
I'm going to be a little bit of a
Looks like we have a call. There's some very intrusive today, aren't they?
That's tickets Winter Garden
through the. Oh, that's real clever. That's real clever.
Excuse me. Rodolfo, how could you?
You want your name made fun of on
there? There might be a special premium for a $50 level. That would be instead of the T-shirt and the
Any
symbol of what we stand for.
All taken by you. The show and
All you wouldn't understand.
Whatever was ringing, all you need to do is pick up the phone. And then say, UFB,
this one was printed. This is very right. So don't throw this one away.
Yeah, we're going to have a 136
away. I'm going to print a new one.
That's for mushrooms and roses.
We changed the print.
Oh, okay.
And this is a business donation.
Okay, we want
and you put your 30s. And you also have to try to ask them what their favorite show is.
Oh, okay. Show
and
Lodge Project and the Saturday Party.
No need to freak out yet. Everything's under control.
Okay, there you go.
Let's follow a pledge.
Another one. Oh, dear.
You have to change the show code and everything on this. This is Worcester now.
Yeah, well, we'll change the show now. So we want...
That's all they wanted to know, eh? There's a light flashing that says caution. I don't know what that means. Caution either means low battery or the end of the tape.
Very good possibility.
Just heard a little click. Well, something's going to happen. Something's going to happen. We don't know what yet, but the caution light is flashing.
This is similar to the definitely.
We're about to have a critical meltdown of some sort. I would suspect it's the...
Oh, no.
Susan is here.
Oh, no.
Hi.
She does that so well.
Hi.
Hi, Susanna.
What do you think the flashing caution light means?
I think it means that you're liable to be bothered. How are you? Stop filming.
I just want to dump out.
Hi, Mom.
Maybe. Maybe the battery is running low. We're all speeding up now. Because
film Lister.
The battery is running low. I did film Lister.
Okay.
I guess I should do something about it.
Hi. How are you? I'm fine. I'm Susan.
Don't shoot rubber bands at me.
Jeannie, I remember you from my school. You do?
Yeah.
No, don't do that.
Before I forget,
no, this is like in the
guy
that
we are
going to
stop this. Oh, I know you
were going to. I hate it when people shoot rubber bands. One thing I can't stand.
You know it works now.
Got him on the run.
Oh.
I know their names.
Oh, okay, while I was dropping the camera, though, I noticed that the red light here says battery caution, which means this is indeed a battery problem. I will now stop this and replace the battery.
Say, Jim Weir, are these...
It's so funny because, you know, you get to know people over the years, you know, on the phone.
Norm has the machine out.
I have the machine out.
Wow, it's a very exciting machine.
These are the sort of people you want to, like, call at parties.
What did you have to do to get that machine?
Like, you got to disregard.
What do we have to do?
Disregard.
Yeah.
They will stuff in your face.
First
and they
of all,
you've got
to find
them.
Will you stop with the rubber bands?
I don't even care.
Tell them to stop shooting rubber bands at me.
Well, we spoke with the bank that we deal with,
Daddy,
and the bank has a procedure where you become a merchant. And you fill out a lot of application forms and pieces of paper, and you pay, I guess, about a total of about $65 to $80 for a machine and some other filing fee. Yeah. And then they send you all kinds of nifty things in the mail, ranging from... the scoundrels of week to week have bogus credit cards to all kinds of authorization codes that you have to call in if the credit card's above a certain amount of money, and all kinds of paraphernalia about Visa and MasterCard, as well as the thing that people
colorful
will die for. And that, of course, are the two actual stick-on MasterCard
labels,
which we have not yet found a place that's appropriate for them. So
why don't we put them on our cars?
They will remain in this box from this window.
Now, can you demonstrate how the machine works?
Well, not quite yet.
Where do you plug it in?
You don't plug it in. It doesn't plug in anywhere.
It operates on batteries. How about that?
It doesn't operate. It operates on
solar
wrist,
power.
Manual labor.
Power here.
It's the most incredible machine, isn't it?
If you're still with us in a minute or two, maybe I'll run that one for you.
Okay, we'll be working forward to that with great anticipation.
So what's new since yesterday?
You need to change the morning total?
Oh, yeah, I should, subtract from that.
So, it's melting now, though.
Yeah, it's getting really snow because it goes away right.
It's getting really nice out.
Put the numbers on it, but that, you know.
Okay, it's
we're
following a pledge here.
All right, so that's the $50 pledge, then.
This is a pledge for $50.
Yeah, I'll be titled for these. Do you know what they are?
This phone.
He says it on the air.
All the way over there.
All
the
he's daily for now.
Well,
he's for in studio.
Right.
Yeah, for his phone purposes.
All righty. Okay, bye. Yeah, I guess so. Okay.
Jerry, give me that.
Good. I haven't seen any yet. They sure did, I know.
Basic information is being filled out there?
Hey, yeah. Uh-huh. You know who's really
good?
Did you
know
girls yet? Oh. Well, aren't they?
It's cute.
Thanks. Did you see that? Yes. Yeah.
I'm sorry, is there a problem?
Really?
There?
Yeah, they're good.
Right.
Okay, John, so it's a week from... It'll be a week from this Sunday. Yeah, what you think is the 22nd? No, this Sunday's Easter.
14th.
I think it's the
no, next Sunday.
Yeah, no, okay.
No, next Sunday.
It's on Easter?
It's
on Easter. Let me write it down.
Okay.
You want to leave one here?
You'll work it out, okay.
Lister.
Okay,
leave
John.
One here for now, and I'll bring it in.
All right,
here.
We're going to follow that pledge.
Okay.
Okay.
From the moment of this inception.
All right, thank you. Tell Larry to move. Out of my way.
That's good. Okay, but I said it myself. Okay. Hi, right, thanks
you know
a lot. Bye bye.
Woody's in the village.
Okay, here you go. No problem.
Thank you.
Oh, they're not making a pledge. Okay, follow this one.
Now, what do I put up here?
This lady wants the address and the phone number of Woody's in the village. Do we have that information?
Do we look like information?
Tell her to call information.
It's on 4th Street in Manhattan. That's where all you can call it.
It's 133 now.
What?
That's
the one I have.
Oh, okay.
Thanks.
Ma'am? Somebody said that it's somewhere on 4th Street in Manhattan. It's probably your best bet with call information.
You want me to call the deli team?
Phone number
yeah.
Okay, we're going to follow this
alrighty.
One.
Alrighty. Goodbye.
Who's going to take this one?
Sensitive material.
Right.
Put them in a drawer, in the cup drawer, and hopefully I'll remember before the radio time.
Fine.
And the only person who's free right now is here.
Actually,
yes, of
Jim,
course.
We need to give. Where's that master list of it?
Take this to Lister. Tell Lister he has a personal
phone. I got the package list.
On hold, and you need
and new number.
Oh.
Yeah, 9007. Put 9007 where it says premium number. And
nine,
what is it?
9007?
Wait.
Have we been doing the normal $50 regular pledge for the Aztec two-step creating numbers? Since?
I don't think, I haven't seen many numbers. I haven't been here when we did them, and
right,
I know
so
you guys gave away some.
Right, so probably is just the regular, but it's not just the $8.
Is $10, and they're getting a mug?
He gave a $50 pledge. So Norm just said the Aztec two-step gets that
right.
Plus.
Value is, hang on a second, there's $10
okay.
A ticket, 20.
$28, $29, $30, $31, $32, $33, $34.
I'll leave these over on the piano sometime being. No, put them in the drawer, because I'm going to... Put them in the bottom drawer, I guess. That's fine. That's where we used to put records, so I remember. Pair of tapes. Okay, when it calms down, I'm going to call for food. So you guys decide what kind of deli food you want.
It's not going to calm down. I'll never calm down.
I'm sorry, thank you.
Thank you very much. Cheers.
Everybody, by the way, when you mention, when you ask them if they want their name mentioned on there, it's only their first name that gets mentioned.
Oh, he said fine. He's won tickets here many times.
No, I'm saying people have been saying just do you want their name mentioned
on
there. It's just the first name.
Are you sure
that
two LPs, so make sure LPs like the
second.
Some people don't mind the first name, but do mind the last name. But the last name never shows up on the screen.
Oh, okay. I'm ready to say that. Thank you. What did I number that first card?
We do.
All right.
Actually, we did.
I didn't number anything, did I?
Number. Morning.
No, come on. Lucky.
Hey,
I didn't say it was on.
No, you're getting
I know, that's what everybody
says. How you doing?
Pretty good, how are you?
All right.
Like 1, 2, 3.
Are you here to help?
Everybody you saw, we've got solar all the time. I mean, nobody ever stopped going.
Amazing.
6, 1, 2, 3, 8. That's Vic, the program director of WUSB. Well, that's Jim Wiener's head in his way. Oh, okay, that's better.
See, what I mean, Eric, by constraint is not that people have secrets that they have to hide from you. It's just that if people are trying to move around and talk to them in a normal way and act in a normal way, they can't.
Jim, the media is here to help you.
Pardon?
The media is here to help you, and your hostility towards the media is
my hostility
going to be portrayed in this documentary.
The media?
Yes.
No. Eric, my hostility isn't towards the media, it's towards you personally. That's really, the media has nothing to do with it.
Let's see if the American public buys that, Jim.
Is it the mushroom and roses?
Eric, the American public told me I should be hostile.
Fundamental.
I've gotten millions of letters from people.
And there are a couple.
This is the kind of stuff he reads all the time.
Right.
It's okay, we're only kidding.
And they got the community cinema. I got a call.
See, but I have to keep pushing my head back like this, you know.
It says they're going to get
it's like I'm a subway worker, you know.
In actuality, it's $10.
Waiting for a train to go.
Did I know that?
No, they didn't know that when they got this thing. So I wasn't a little surprised. I'm going to call New Community first. See if they can convert that to tickets.
Pull
that one, and then I'll call them and I'll work something out with
them. Well, we're going to give that guy...
They had a problem with their tickets last year, so they know...
We're going to give that guy Broadway show, right?
Tickets to Tangy Broadway.
All right. Call him. He can give them away. No?
I got 15 pairs of tickets for Tangy Broadway.
Great, 15 pairs of tickets,
man. Ross Marvin called, and Ross Marvin says he's going to release 5 subscriptions to Abyssinian News for Lister. It's a $10. I mean, a $10.
Vic, you want to help Lister?
$25.
Do a wrap with Lister?
I'll definitely do that. I'll do that right away.
Now that's how much the tickets cost, $11.
$15 tickets.
We got 15 carats of Santa Bernhardt tickets
on the end,
and they're $15 a piece.
Oh, yes.
Excuse me, I'm sorry, Eric.
Some, $25 plate.
Eric, I'm sorry.
Yeah,
I
you should be, but go ahead.
There's a bunch of kidneys. It's a lot better.
No, it's okay.
It's all right.
Okay.
I only
trip. Don't trip, Eric.
I didn't even take anything.
The gourmet cookies are excellent.
Whose pocketbook is this?
As much as I can taste the stuff.
You know, with all the...
Yeah, oh, sure.
We've got
no, your number here.
The what?
Just give me some more to write.
Okay, hang on. Let me number them first. 4, 5, 7, 1, 4, 6, 8, 7, 1, 4, 8, 8.
Jim, are you
listening for
me?
Give me some
rubber bands.
All right,
7.
Mike, shut
the
mic.
When
did
Michelle play?
Michelle
played after my show was over, at some point.
She played yesterday, too. She played yesterday. She played yesterday afternoon.
Jerry, can we have some rubber bands, please?
Oh, you mailing
and she won a contest, too, yeah.
For now, this... Oh, that's right. She pledged to eat dinner at
the... Oh, you were college
student? She didn't want that. She did.
Yeah, Marsha
was one.
That's pretty funny, actually. Shelly Thunder's the other. We didn't have a budget, right?
What do we have for Shelly Thunder?
Album, you want it?
No, I have it.
Get another one. Okay, could
you... Well, the one I have doesn't have a...
Wasn't she here yesterday? How come I didn't see her?
Who was here yesterday?
I thought she was. I thought I heard on the radio.
Shelly Thunder?
Shelly Thunder.
Thank you. Excuse me.
No, it was an interview with her.
She lied on the air. Why did she lie?
Quad?
Six.
Q-U-A-D?
Okay,
look at these. It's not been a whole week now. Jerry, I have had like one call after another.
How would you mess it up? Visa, MasterCard, check or money. Oh, or cash.
Who put the DK and bumper sticker on Norm's refrigerator?
Okay. You'll be giving it to
me. Where is that? I didn't see it.
It's a black and white one.
Huh.
It's very nice one. What one is
it? I don't know.
Okay,
the consensus seems to be that those bumper stickers are hard to see.
Are we you can have TVs they want. Thank you very
we
much.
Have three lines with there. I think that's two lines.
We have a CD for Tracy Chapman. That's right. Yeah.
Okay.
All right, let's get some information then, okay?
I don't think this drum is right now.
Well, I think
if the phone rings again, I might have to answer it and then I have to drop the camera.
Okay. Well, it's 7 times 12.
Okay, and it's a 5 year old information. Okay. Did we do another brother?
I don't
know. Man, there's no class.
I think this is very important that we talk to people as they're busy doing what they do best.
What's that?
Well, what is this? What is it that you're doing?
This
here?
Is a cryptic quote.
Uh-huh. It looks like you're very close to solving it.
Well, yeah, they're...
But Davis is an expert on this.
When you do them every day like I do, you get certain little clues that make it pretty easy to do these things.
What is this called? Cinema?
Verite?
Yeah. It's some French word I couldn't pronounce.
Very good answer.
Where were you with that thing during the Halloween party, Eric, when we...
I didn't have this thing then.
You did?
I didn't.
You didn't?
I just got it.
You know, it's a sight worth taking movies about that.
Well, I've got a Halloween party a couple of years ago.
And finally, is it possible for us to have, like...
Oh, yes, go ahead. Just walk right in front of the lens.
A pound of, like, lettuce and tomato salad or something like that. And a pound of maybe spinach.
She's been giving an order on the telephone. She's very good at giving orders. That's what we pay her for.
Okay. So mushroom and maybe some sort of like green salad, something you feel is healthy. Great. And that's the stuff. And also, I would like to bring you guys some like books or records or something.
Maybe?
How many people are working there today? Mm-hmm. Is that many? Sure.
Uh-huh.
Good.
Okay, I'll bring a bunch of stuff and you guys can choose between them, okay? I really thank you very much. I'll be there in about, I guess in about half hour,
45 minutes, is that that? Okay. Let me see, let me just see how many total I gave you, so we can check. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Right, I got 12 salads, 12 sandwiches, plus 2 here, that's 14, 16, 18, that's right. Thank you again, Ginger, see you later. Bye-bye.
That's Seaport?
You're so close. You must have, like, my nose in some.
No, I could zoom in on it.
No, please, no, no.
Yeah, let's do that.
My eyes.
Oh, my
nice
goodness,
eyes.
Look at that. Yeah, you do have nice eyes.
Thank you.
Let's explore this.
Come on,
are you going,
I'm
going
to go thank them on air.
Going to where?
Seaport. I'm going to go pick up Don.
Do you want me to go help you get them?
I'm going to pick up Don, so I'm going to take him to help me.
Okay.
I have to go pick him up anyway. Let's go thank
I can help you too, you know, because they know me.
Was that a good idea to get him, like, 14 records and stuff?
Sure.
Maybe they'll do it again for us.
Let me go with you.
Okay.
Let's talk to Lister.
I mean, there's a struggle over here. She's still going to get the next score. So how about $135 throw it my way? $10 would be good because it would get you the program guide, wouldn't it?
That would be, right? Program guide would be nice so you can see all the specials that we're going to have.
Right.
Lister.
Yeah.
There's some really nice people at Seaport Deli.
Oh.
And they've heard us do this work up here, and I'd like to thank them for helping us, sustaining us through this radiothon. Seaport Deli, that's on 25A and Setauket, right?
Yeah.
That's Setauket.
It makes me feel hungry, and I can't eat anything until we really hit the financial halfway mark. On the clock, we're like 3 minutes behind, and we're only $135 short, which is not bad. Seriously, think about it. $10 would help out. $20 would make a big individual support, isn't it?
If one person calls up and pledges $90.1, it'll help out so much.
Oh, yeah, that's true, too, man.
But everything will help out. Every penny that you can give us will help us out.
That's
please.
Right.
Give us a call, 632-6901. I know there are people listening to you who sometimes can get you and sometimes can't because they live in those fringe areas,
mm-hmm.
you know, like Huntington. That's not that far away, but we're being crowded out. And any amount of pledge that you give us will make sure that you can get us better, too. You can get us clearer, sharper all the time.
Let's double that number. 12 callers. We want to double that number, 12 to 24.
Ah.
Really. 4 minutes past the halfway mark, $135 off target. And we have faith in you. We're going to give you the music. We're going to give you every pledge that we can give away. We've given away tickets to go see Alpha Blondie. I mean, ask Nick. Nick called up and we delivered. And I'm going to play the Alpha Blondie record, seriously. But I want to be over El Segundo, over the halfway mark. The Visa card thing is happening, isn't it?
The Visa card, the MasterCard thing is happening. It's quick and it's easy. Just 2 minutes, and you can sit back and enjoy the whole radio.
We only have one phone call, one caller on the line. I don't believe it.
You know, I've been here on Saturday.
I can't believe it.
And the phones ring off the hook. People call for requests all the time.
Mister, I can't believe it.
Hey, if you've called for a request in the past and you've gotten it, think of where you'd have to go to get it in the future if we're not around, folks.
One phone call. We can't believe it.
Come on, let's get five phone calls. 632-6901. It's as easy as that.
Light up the trees. Lister looks hungry.
Yeah, let's hear the sound of the telephones ring, jing-a-ling-a-ling, ding, ding, ding.
I'm gonna go.
It's in the past. We got gas. It went on to get rough. It was a nice little pump in the
that's
middle.
That's why I need to talk it.
Anywhere we look in that. I order it.
You come out here from New York City, you know, every week. You could have gone to Jamaica instead of being here.
Yeah, it is. It is
the people on the eastern end of Long Island. Being on here is a little bit better. The folks in
too bad.
Connecticut can hear us a little bit better.
Yeah, but you're putting everyone else on camera.
I don't care about particularly else. On West Meadow Beach, we need to hear from you right
okay,
now. At 516-632-6901. Let's make it tangible. Let's give Lister a little bit of extra support here.
Jimmy, come in here. Come in. Let's see.
Come in. What for?
3 East 47, we're stuck out. We want to get over the hump. In the next 30 minutes.
More than yeah, in other words, if you come, you have to
stay.
We can
get to 900.
$50
from 6 first.
Oh,
I'm
saying.
Absolutely. Matter of fact, one way of looking at it is for those of you that most of the WUSB that are occasionally annoyed by a drifting away of the signal.
In other words, you're coming from Connecticut.
You can help us put a stop to that.
Okay. Street. Okay, city.
$900
gold. Thank
you. Can you
bless your mouth? Pong
pong.
But you, I can't laugh. Oh, and I can't.
And
what? No. Why?
Is
it in your office closed?
Do you want to be mentioned on the air, sir?
Like this. You can't do it? You look like you really mean it.
Like this.
See, his eyes go dark.
Okay, who will be making the donation? Your company or you?
Sorry, how many people have been here?
Let me just write down this information.
Want to open this? Can we open this? Okay, let's see here.
If I need anything else from you. Do you have any
people to get cracking on?
Yes, do you
well, text this person.
Right, okay.
You've already text enough. Speaking of which.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you very much for pledging.
Okay, first of all, may I see your IRS identification,
yes,
you please?
Yes.
Red pen? Red pen is my IRS identification.
That's right. All you need.
That changes everything. Okay, how much do you want? Okay.
Your responsibility to figure that out.
Yeah, that's another thing I'd like to take up with you. On top of having to pay all this money, what if you do all this work for the government?
Actually, you don't. You have the right to have your taxes figured out.
Yeah, I know. Let the government figure it out for you.
It's an alien right.
True. We have directories.
Yeah. You know, it seems to me... Well, I see what you mean. Yeah, it's six of one, half a dozen of the other. You don't want the
what
government...
What does that mean? I've always wondered what that meant.
Okay.
And not as good as a wink to a blind to us.
Right. See. Right.
Well, I think you've gotten the caravan's attention on that one.
Oh, no. I got a credit card.
Hold on. Eddie, you know what?
Okay, great.
I think it's been reassigned.
To a 6,000 number?
No.
Did we have celebrating your anniversary? I'll mail this to you in my house.
Let's see, I gotta find that.
There's quite an incredible load of people in the room right now.
Quite an amazingly large capacity for human life held within these walls here at the radio station at this time.
Cool, thank you. Great, thank
very
you
good.
So much for your support. It's always nice to hear from you guys. Thank you. You too, please tell Mr. Cabana it's a happy anniversary.
Take
care. Okay, enjoy the music.
Bye-bye.
So funny.
I'm glad somebody thinks it's funny.
Well, the joke was on them last year.
I knew that was really on the last year. I mean, these
did he give him something that's going to be canceled also this year?
Yeah, chorus one.
No.
Pins
are
on. Vinegar.
Oh, yeah, didn't you hear about
it's
that?
People in Connecticut.
They
recalled
we have any
it.
Palm Mary
it's strychnine.
Any
they
Palm Mary tickets, right?
Remember this call?
Oh, they're going to have random.
Yes, I took that. We have any Palm Mary tickets?
I took that call last year.
What?
They're called Connecticut, right?
No.
Yeah.
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 Now, wait a second. Jim, don't you leave.
I'm not. I'm right here.
Did we need to tell Sue the status of the diplomatic butter stuff?
Okay. Oh, no, I think that's
no,
really worked out.
I'm thinking of calling her again. Wait, let's get one thing.
Why don't you just go out and visit her? Take less
exotic butter. Exotic butter. That's what they're talking about.
Now remember, the bottom line is everyone have fun.
Can I break the lens again?
Is everybody having fun?
Yeah.
That's the bottom line.
He was at least still smiling.
I caught him. And I said, what? Unless he's called Tim. I called him two nights ago.
What's his problem?
No, he doesn't have a problem.
He had a fire inspection.
Like,
I know you're going to be shocked by the news, but this is apparently quite a treasure. It's supposedly Lister Gates. It's the way to
do it. Is it a premium?
Guys.
Are you running?
I'm going to just put my hat over here.
So I don't know what
from the nose down, you say,
sure.
Oh, God. Well, here's my gas card.
No, wait.
So
wait,
I'll show the number.
No, it's not going
to trust Eric for those kind of things.
I mean, not have.
He has
the number. This is Eric Kelly talking about.
Excuse me, I mean, I have much fun in it. They don't have to
go out
and
talk to you. My kids when they were babies.
Oh, great. Thank you very much.
Stapler. Thank you.
I'd like to be able to film those guys, you know, playing music.
Oh, you better go get another tape.
Yeah, I'm not sure how much I have.
Never push this lid down.
These mushrooms.
Actually, I did that before.
Are very famous. Angle it down.
Famous mushrooms.
Famous Seaport Deli mushrooms.
And today only, there are large.
Here we go. I'm enjoying a Seaport Deli.
Dude, and you put the fork right back.
I don't know where the fork was either.
Jim Dexter.
You know why you never got tickets?
It's aerial view time.
An aerial view.
Wait, the mushrooms are for late night, Jim. Not now.
Bald spot.
Okay. Mushrooms are for when everybody's going home or at their home. No mushrooms when this work.
Look at the moon.
Here's another kind of mushroom.
Yeah. Oh my God.
Yeah, it's shocking. I didn't realize that.
You know, no, it's mushrooms are very poor.
Mushrooms are really good until they are fungus.
Now say that in a Scottish accent.
Okay, so I don't put in the
mushrooms are quite the tasty thing you put in the most. That is until you realize that they're fungus.
Angus.
Angus, what do you mean?
It's fun, Gordon. What do you mean?
Do you mean?
You know what I did this morning? I want to tell you, talk about